Sharks and snakes may seem like they belong in completely different worlds. But what if those worlds collided? Millions of years ago, two terrifying predators ruled the Earth, one in the vast, deep oceans and the other in the steamy tropical swamps. Megalodon, the ultimate apex predator of the sea, and Titanoboa, the colossal constrictor of the land and rivers, were both unmatched in their time. While they never faced off in reality, we can only imagine the epic showdown between their size, power, and primal ferocity. This is Megalodon versus Titanoboa, the prehistoric clash of the giants. Stick around till the end, because this battle is unlike anything you've ever seen before. Before we jump into this prehistoric smackdown, let's meet the two terrifying titans that once ruled Earth. First up, we have Megalodon, the largest shark to ever cruise the oceans. This ancient beast could grow over 67 feet long, and with a weight of up to 50 tons, it was basically a swimming bulldozer with teeth. Its jaw could open more than 6 feet wide and held over 250 serrated teeth, each about the size of a steak knife. This wasn't just for show. Megalodon had a bite force of over 40,000 pounds. That's powerful enough to crush a whale's ribcage like a soda can. Now slithering in from the shadows, Titanoboa, the largest snake the planet has ever seen. Titanoboa was a 50-foot-long, 1-ton monster that made today's anacondas look like garden hoses. It lived around 60 million years ago in the hot, swampy jungles of what's now northern South America. And here's the thing, it didn't need venom. Titanoboa was a constrictor, meaning it killed by wrapping around its prey and squeezing. And this is not just a little hug. This is a full-body, bone-crushing grip that could stop your heart and break your ribs all at once. Now let's dive into a hypothetical showdown where both these titans meet head-to-head. This is a scenario where the environment isn't a factor. No shallow waters or tight spaces, just a pure battle of strength, speed, and power. In the first round, Titanoboa, with its mastery of ambush tactics, might attempt to strike first. Lying motionless in the water, it could wait for Megalodon to come within range, then explode into action, trying to coil around the shark with deadly precision. But Megalodon isn't just some slow-moving prey. It's a torpedo of speed and aggression. If it gets the first strike, those massive jaws could tear through Titanoboa's body in a matter of seconds. Titanoboa might not even have time to react. The battle would be over before the snake even got a chance to wrap around. But let's say Titanoboa does get its coils around Megalodon. Round two becomes a contest of pure power. The snake's constriction is incredibly strong. It could squeeze with enough force to crush bones and even stop the shark from breathing. Megalodon, though, is a beast in its own right, and it's built to endure. It has the sheer strength to break free, but Titanoboa's grip could delay it long enough to cause significant damage. However, no matter how tight Titanoboa squeezes, it still faces a massive disadvantage. Megalodon's sheer size, along with its speed and power, would eventually overwhelm the snake. One well-placed bite could rip through Titanoboa's thick body, ending the battle before it could squeeze the life out of the shark. So, who wins? In this hypothetical battle, it's clear that Megalodon's raw power and speed would give it a major advantage. A single bite from those massive jaws would likely end the fight quickly. While Titanoboa is no slouch and would give it a solid effort with its constriction, Megalodon's sheer size and predatory instincts make it the more dangerous opponent in this scenario. In a direct head-to-head battle, Megalodon takes the win. Thanks for tuning in to our epic showdown between the Megalodon and Titanoboa. If you enjoyed exploring interesting stories with us, don't forget to hit that subscribe button. What topics do you want us to dive into next? Let us know in the comments. Join us as we get animated about science here at Animated Science.